Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you know my channel, I'm Akanksha. I know Glam Sham. Who is she? I can't stop looking at myself. I just love how this look turned out from the time I'm done. I'm just like, who is this beauty? Okay. So anyways, I wanted to do a look which is very universal. Black and gold is an evergreen combination. You can do this on literally any look. Bridal look, bridesmaid, any function, just about the choice. If you want to go something which super glam and super smoky, you can always do this. And just look, I should have added probably a mom tika, no? But it would have been too much. It's okay. You can add if you want to, but this is about makeup. But it just looks so good, right? So I don't know what else to say. This looks really nice, and if you want to see how I went from this to this, then please keep on watching. So let's start off with skin prep, which is a must before you do your makeup, like I always tell you. Now usually if you're going to do your makeup, it's either to click pictures or to go out, right? So either way, you are going to be exposed to the sun and you need to protect your skin from the sun. So you have to wear your sunscreen to protect yourself from the sun. You have to wear sunscreen to protect yourself from the sun. So today I'm going in with the Requel Zinc Sunscreen. This is a 100% mineral sunscreen. Yay, Requel finally launched the mineral sunscreen, and this one is extremely good for one more reason, is that it doesn't leave any white cast. Usually mineral sunscreens tend to do that, but this one is a tinted sunscreen, so it does not leave any white cast. And one more amazing thing, I know it gets better, is it has no fragrance also. So ultimately it's like one of the sunscreen which is suited for that extremely sensitive skin, because actually acne prone skin and any skin type, because it's non-comedogenic, it has no fragrance, no skin irritants, and some mineral sunscreen, so it won't react to your skin with your skin really weirdly or anything, and it has no white cast. So overall I really like this one. Sunscreen tends to have this a tinted color, like you would feel like it might leave a stain on your skin, but it's a sunscreen, so it does not have like extreme coverage. The tint is just there for it to, like, you know, remove that white cast. So I'll just apply the sunscreen on only one side of my face so that you can see the difference between this side and this side. So this is like a matte sunscreen. You have to work it into your skin. So you can see this side and this side. So that hint is just there to remove that tiny white cast which you may have, and also it kind of creates like a smooth layer. So you can use this like a tinted, you know, BB cream or moisturizer, how it gives that minimal, you cannot see much of difference. So you can wear it on your own, you can wear it underneath the makeup, like how I'm going to today. See, where's the white cast? There's no white cast. So the sunscreen is really good. Like I told you, anybody can use it. Sensitive skin, acne prone skin, it, because it's non-comedogenic, no skin irritants. It's SPF 50 PA++. You get 50 grams of product for ₹7.95. So if you're interested to buy this, then check the link in the description box. One thing I just want you to keep in mind, if you're using this, is it is a tinted one. So, you know, you might transfer it somewhere. You should just keep that in mind, but you know, rest is like a normal, how it is like a regular sunscreen. So yeah, let's start off with makeup. I'm in a mood to get glam. I've not done Indian glam in a minute. I think it's been a while. I think last I did was like for Diwali or something. So let's get started. Also, one last thing, if you want to purchase any Requel products, you can use my code AKANKSHAK to get a little bit of discount. I didn't want to do a voiceover for this video, but the construction sound started and I didn't have any options. So let's start off my staple, my skin prep. I'm doing it with the MAC Fix Plus. Then today I'm going to first contour before I go in with my foundation. I like to do this when I want my contour to be strong, but also, like, you know, to blend into my skin really well. So before applying foundation, if I do this, it kind of blends into my skin really well and it won't look as harsh, but will still give me dimension. So I'm just applying it and, you know, blending it out. Usual places how I do contouring video is coming soon for sure. Then I'm just mixing my favorite foundations of all time, Maybelline Fit Me and NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop. I took a very light amount and I'm just, like, you know, tapping it on the skin and blending it out. You can see I'm going very light-handed, the contour is still seen. I'm not using like a full coverage product where the contour would disappear, because I did a lot of work for that to be there. So I'm just, like, you know, taking a small amount and just working into the skin and blending it out really well. I'm just going in back with the same brush which I use for contour and blending the edges again so that it's a lot smoother. Then I'm using the Clinique concealer. I'm in love with this concealer these days. It is so beautiful. The shade is not my match. I got this in PR, so I'm just mixing two shades. I'll put the shades in the description. So applying it and blending it out again blends very beautifully and very nicely. I really like how it looks. It's just so super creamy. If you have especially dry under eyes, then you should definitely try this one. It'll be like a lifesaver for y'all. Then I'm going in with the Daughter Earth, the lip and cheek tint. I've spoken about this in the previous video as well. I've been obsessing over this. It's so beautiful for a blush. Look at my face. I was just so impressed. The color is really nice. Such a warm tone. But you have to be careful. Don't take too much because it's very pigmented. But if you take a small amount and blend it into your skin, it just looks very nice. Then again, Laura Mercier powder, just lightly dusting it off on the entire face and a little more heavier on the under eyes because I don't want it to crease. Then going in with the NYX bronzer, going over the same place. I'm not applying too much bronzer because I already applied cream contour. I'm just like slightly touching it on top of it. Next, it's an irrelevant step, but I'm just lining my lips using the PAC lip liner because my lips were looking too pale and I didn't like it. Then I'm using the e.l.f. Instant Brow Pencil and just shaping out my brows. You guys know I don't do much to my brows. Very, very minimal. I just fill in the starting where I feel like I have a little bit of gaps and I brush my hair through it. Just gives that shape. This is my favorite part, is shaping my brow using a concealer because it adds a lot of definition and instantly lifts my eyebrows. So I just use the same NYX concealer. Then now I'm going in with the LA Girl eyeshadow palette. It's their Pro Artistry eyeshadow palette. I'm just going in with a soft brown and building it in the crease. Now, crease really determines how your entire eye looks. So I'm just building it up and pulling it outwards on the edge. You can see I'm trying to lift it up on the edges so that my eyes look a lot lifted and open. Then I'm going with a dark brown and defining the crease now, adding a lot of dimension. I'm going in with a very small teeny brush and defining it and blending it out. So yeah, blend. Going in back with that light transition shade and blending out the dark brown so that there is no harsh edges. Then I'm going in back with black to add even more intensity and depth. So just slowly building up. You should be very careful with black because a little goes a really long way. So don't take a lot of black because you'll end up looking like a panda. Take little amounts, add, keep adding, keep building and blend it out. Then next I'm just adding concealer on the lid where I want to apply a shimmer shade. I'm not doing like a cut crease because I want it to be more smoky and blended out, but just adding it a little bit there so that, you know, the shade really grabs onto the concealer. And I use those two metallic shades like you saw. Then I'm going in back with the same two browns I used on the lid on the lower lash line as well. Now you can add kajal there if you want, but I don't really use, like, you know, usually prefer kajal that much, so I did not do that. Then I'm going in with the Makeup Revolution Flick eyeliner and I'm doing a small tiny wing. And now this part really amplified the look a lot. Now I did a proper intense foxy eye. I literally tried to change the shape of my eye. I usually I just do a tiny bit with like a brow pencil or something, but this time I kind of like drew a literal fake foxy eye to just give that dimension to my eye and make it look so elongated and sexy. Next, I'm going in with the MAC Fix Plus to just set my face before I go in with a highlighter. I'm using the BAM Cosmetics highlighter, my all-time favorite highlighter. Remember, you want everything to look very soft and blended out. Don't pile your face with highlighter. Apply it and blend it out so that it just looks like a touch of glow. When the light hit, it's not, and not something which looks like a chunk of glitter on your face. So I'm adding the same highlighter in the inner corner as well. I'm connecting it to the shimmer, gold shimmer, which I added in the lid. Next, I'm going in with this dark brown lipstick from Ciate London. I really like this brown. It's like an intense dark brown lipstick. So just adding that. Next, I'm obsessed with gloss these days. So I'm going in with Too Faced Lip Plumping Gloss, adding it in the center of the top lip and the bottom lip. Then going in with lashes and voila! Who is this beauty? Hold on. Do you see what is missing? This is something I always do, and I forgot in this video, I forgot to highlight my nose. So yeah guys, that's it for this look. I can't stop staring at myself. I really like how this look turned out. Now of course, instead of brown lipstick, you can go for red or nude or anything according to your taste. I just went with brown because I was feeling that vibe, and you know, it looks really nice. Black and gold is an evergreen combination. Nothing beats it. So yeah, like you can see my base looks very, very flawless. The sunscreen does not affect your base or anything if you're worried about that. Just acts like a normal sunscreen. So yeah, with that we finished this video. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. We have a fun time here. Keep watching my videos and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.